I've been itching to get up in the garden, so much so that I locked myself out of the house this morning. Just, I was that itching to get up there. I forgot, my daughter works in the village as well, so I couldn't go and get some keys to get back in. Then I get up here and I forgets the cameras. I brings all the tools and forgets the cameras, you know what I mean? So I had to go all the way back. Man, anyway, but I'm here. And what I want to do, well, let's see what, come with this and I'll show you. What I want to do today is this side of the garden has, it's kind of fallout from building, you know, doing all this and the flagstones and everything, which I'm very happy about, is it's been a little bit, well, let's say, not neglected, just like the fallout, the kind of collateral damage, you know, there's boards missing along there, there's all the boards off there, this is all damaged. I've got this wood now, the intention was to do raised beds like these ones here, but I'm thinking for now I might just do a single raise around, and not just around, this is the thing I'm thinking of, is I'm going to do, like, I like this contained style area. It's like, it's manageable. And it feels like you've achieved something once you've, like, say, tidied one bed out. So what I'm intending to do is possibly on these two today is build like a single tier frame like this with a little path in the middle. Nothing kind of massive a path, but, and that would actually, you know, I'm not that bothered about that charred anyways, but this, I would like to keep that, you know, sprouting broccoli, because it's coming on. It's coming on actually quite nice, if you can see there. So I'll be able to build a frame around that. That's the intention anyways. And there's the wood there. And if I've got any, like, little spare bits, you see that little spare bit up there? Can you see that? I'm intending to, just, we'll go down here, is build a frame there. Maybe a two-tier frame to put some fruit in, but we'll see. That's all in the future. That's all right there. So that's the intention. Say hello to Daisy. She's got a new bed. Unfortunately, my mum lost her dog Wilson after 17 years, I think he was. But man, he was a good old age there. And it's a great little bed, and I'll actually take that bed, that home, that's not a bed, it's a seat cover, and get it washed and that. But that's Daisy's official blanket there now. Hello, dears. Hello, lads. Right. So, come on now, let's get work done. Obviously, I've got to kind of use this length, which is longer than what most of my beds are about 7-8 foot roughly. This is actually, that's 9 foot, which is not bad, you know what I mean? 9 foot by, say, 3 foot. Was it 9 foot? Another look. All my tools have got this kind of coating of cement dust. Yeah, 9 foot. And actually, that would work out, because then I could, that'd be 12 foot, which would be there. Right. And that would give us a nice little spare cut off. That's right, you see. That would give us a nice little bit of a cut to build the fruit box at the end. Right, come on then. New pencil. The reason as well, while I'm going to go this way, because for some reason I always thought I would be going this way, is this way I'm facing south with more exposed land. Oh, that's the theory. Right. He gets the blood pumping. They've done like two sections of it. So I've cut it there for two beds. That's all done. So 9 foot by 3 foot, and we scoot over. There's the ones for the other bed. That's another video later on. But look what I've went and done. I'm saying I would like to keep the sprouted broccoli. I went and bloody snapped the head off. And there's not even, what a bloody shame. So that's gone, bugger it. Pick that up. Casualty of war. Right. Oh. And I didn't even hit the bloody thing. Right, I'll get them put together. I think get you spinning all over the place here. Right, pilot drill, that's the secret, pilot holes. This is probably me least, oh God, oh man. My least enjoyable part of gardening is like painting these beds. I don't know why, but, oh man, that come off, eh? Imagine that. I'm just gonna do the edges first, and then once they're built, I'll give them a little tickle over. I seem to get, look at that, straight away. I got paint everywhere, bloody good top. Actually, in one respect, I like this because it doesn't dry your brush out, so I just leave my brush and it comes off pretty quickly. So in the ideal world, you would do this well before you stitch them together, but never mind. Oh, I don't like this at all, you know what I mean? It gets on my bloody nerves, but it's a job that's got to be done, isn't it? To be honest, they're a nice size, them. Really quite like that. They are a bugger to move around though. Do you know what I mean? It's like, they're a ton weight. And I remember when I built these first ones, oh, I hurt myself. You know what I mean? Just trying to kind of lift them and that. And the beauty now is, once I've got it, I can build on top of it if I wanted to, you know, if I wanted to kind of raise them up a little bit. If I'm honest, I'm quite proud of this. It's measurements are right. Right, I gotta get them painted. Then I think I'm just gonna do two at a time. Man, sometimes if I was attaching it, I might put some kind of some braces down, you know, like some extra posts in the corners or something. If I was doing two, I would use like a little metal brace and join the two up. But I might just see if it just sits like this. Give it a coat of paint. Yeah, I really don't like that job of painting them. So what I want to do is set them, but ideally I want to try and set them so I don't lose as much height as possible, you know, maybe put like an inch in the ground. I mean, the bull metal heavy, so they're not going to kind of wobble and go away, but I want to try and keep as much height. But if I have to sacrifice it and bury it in a bit just to get it nice and level, you know, because I've tried my best to get these ones levelish ish. Right, you put this brush down for a bit.
Every fall has a rise, every burn has a flame From foolish to wise, we all bruise the same.
It's way harder than what I thought, to be honest. Unless I'm just not in the mood. But it's the little things that matter. Now, down there when I flag, and I'm not going to flag, I might actually do the bark. But there was wrong, and I want to make sure if ever I do, that's 2 foot. That's pretty perfect, to be honest. Oh, 2 foot and an inch. I give them another little lick of paint. They look better than what I thought. They look more like a raised bed than anything. I couldn't have probably damaged me Sprout and Brackley more if I'd just picked them before I even started this. I've damaged that one over there. It's way harder than what I thought. For some reason, I did that one and it was like easy, but these, I don't know if that's just because I've done two, but it's the same one, but it's way harder. But it certainly makes the garden a little bit nicer in kind of structure. So anyway, definitely gonna get Dan to help us with the next ones. Look after yourself, take good care.